Howdy folks, this is my review of the Leatherman Free P4. I did not get this for free, I purchased this on the first day. So I already have Leatherman Charge TTI, this is my current daily carry. And I have the Leatherman Surge, which I typically use around the shop. Both of these I have in my custom holsters. You can see these on my other videos and order these from Shapeways. And then I'll be designing one for this because they made the Leatherman free so that it can be opened one-handed. But the holster that it comes with right now is got the, at least it's got the button clip. Looks like it'll last a little longer than their normal clips. But they have a nice spring-loaded action here, similar to the spring-loaded action on these guys. So hope to design a similar clip. So onto the actual tool. So I got the P4 simply because I wanted the kind of largest, most versatile size. You can see here that is a hair taller than the Charge, but it's actually a little thinner. Overall weight, they're pretty darn close. I would say this weighs a little bit less, more like the Wave. And the Charge, despite having titanium scales, weighs more than a Wave. I actually gave the Wave to my dad. Sort of wish I would have kept it. I like the Wave a little bit better than the Charge. Alright, so on to the actual tool. So they designed it with magnets. I'll hold it together if I open the right side. What there is two little magnets. They seem to be behind a plastic cover, which is good because neodymium magnets, if that's what they used, don't like shocks, so kind of looks like they protected that. So it is easy to open with one hand, and then you can kind of close it with one hand, and just about as easy. So once open, it's kind of like a butterfly knife, it's just real loose, but has a nice good click when it's done. It has nice rounded edges. So it's a little more comfortable than kind of the scales on here, although this isn't so bad. And then all the tools, rest of the tools, are all accessible on the outside without a fingernail needed. So you can kind of flip up the tool you want, can opener there, push there, and you can pop out the other tools. So that's extremely good compared to the Charge, which is not fun to try to do this one-handed. No, can't do it. So at least on there you can pop out the blades okay and get them put away. But you can't get to any of the inside tools without completely opening it and really needing a fingernail to kind of dig in there and get them out. A couple things from... So I would say this guy is kind of a light tool for Leatherman. It does not have the bit holders, although there is, I believe, a bit extender that goes onto the screwdriver on here. Supposed to thread on or kind of fit on the end of this, and then it doesn't have the kind of eyeglass size screwdriver that comes with the Charge. Otherwise, I like it. It's really fluid right out of the gate. There's a few things on here that I don't like, which is how razor sharp this edge is right here. So when you pop the tools out and it spins on your thumb, that's actually quite sharp. You have to keep your finger dug into the edge there. The blades, not an S30V like the Charge, but we'll see how long the blade lasts. The saw seems to be just about the same. These scissors are improved. If I can find the scissors, see where the scissors are. Scissors are bigger, And they don't require you to fold them the up the wrong way in order to collapse them like the Charge does. And then the serrated blade is very similar, slightly different shape, but otherwise very similar. It's got a little bit of a kind of finer tip on it though. And then the file is the only other kind of thing that I think is a little bit different. Whoops, I forgot all the tools are on the outside. Where's the file here? You kind of push your thumb in the middle, pop everything out. And then the file is kind of a cross file on one side and then more of a wood file on the other side. So it doesn't have the diamond file, which is really good for sharpening tool or drill bits and other things on the go. So it doesn't seem to have that feature. Otherwise, the rest of the bits are all about the same. The can opener, it does have the kind of leather punch here and has this ridiculously tiny ruler, and apparently a pair of a wire strippers there. See how good those work. Grab some wire. Haven't tried this out yet. This is, I think, 22 gauge. Let's see. 18 gauge. So you just kind of stick it in there, I guess. Put your finger there, I assume. Does half the job. Try again here. Yeah, kind of a dirty cut on the wire strippers. That's too bad. But the other ones really never had wire strippers. You could kind of use the cutters as strippers. My charge is an older one that does not have the replaceable cutters. That is one thing that I am glad of is the replaceable cutters up here. So they got a little loop here instead of a belt clip. I think the P2 comes with a belt clip, and the P4 they've said they're going to sell one. But like I said, I'm gonna design my own holster. So there we go. I think it's a pretty good tool. I would consider it an entry-level tool. It might be probably a bit overpriced. I'd wait for a sale on this guy. But otherwise, especially if you like having one-handed operation, which is always good when you're, you know, got your left hand on some wires or something. That's going to be really handy. All right, folks. Thanks for watching.